Hello, this is Maple Story. In order to improve the various situations which need to be solved in the current Maple Story, we have requested the opinions on a set of topics from the discussion board and the user advisory group. Both the discussion board and the user advisory group gave a wide variety of in-depth opinions, and we were able to think a lot about our development direction going forward. We would like to express our gratitude to all players who have been thinking about Maple Story's future. Rather than giving individual answers to each opinion, we will be telling you about the summarized development direction which was decided after reviewing all your opinions. We will be focusing on the direction of the changes the development team has thought of, so it will be easier to predict what future changes may be like. Boss Rewards Reorganization. 1. Boss Rewards Reorganization's Direction. This Boss Rewards Reorganization's direction is focused on two things: suppressing meso inflation and providing a goal to challenge high-tier bosses by providing rewards that match the boss's difficulties. While the current boss rewards are fixed, as the character's level of growth increases, the difficulty of defeating bosses becomes relatively low, reversing the efficiency of boss rewards in specific sections. To solve this issue, we are developing a system where the selling price of intense power crystals changes dynamically by measuring all users' boss clears and difficulty indicators each week. We expect that boss rewards will be more reasonable than they are now, but a sudden change in the amount of mesos acquired can have a big impact on the game economy, so the intense power crystal price changes will be set to be within a maximum of 3% per week. The experience of acquiring mileage will also be improved. The mileage you get from defeating daily bosses will be slightly decreased, but the mileage you get from defeating weekly and monthly bosses will be greatly increased. Also, the mileage given now from certain weekly, monthly bosses will be expanded to be given from all weekly, monthly bosses. Daily bosses will give 30 mileage, weekly bosses will give 200 mileage, and Black Mage will give 1000 mileage. The daily maximum mileage amount will be increased from 5,000 to 10,000 accordingly. Other than that, tradable consumable items will be added to rewards to increase the level of rewards based on boss difficulty. In addition to rebirth flames, things like experience coupons, incredible chaos scrolls of goodness, premium accessory scrolls, premium pet equipment scrolls, and magical scrolls will be added to enhance boss rewards. For the pitched boss set, which is one of the current top-tier boss rewards, we are not reviewing the addition of a ceiling system or significantly increasing the drop rate to reduce the acquisition difficulty. A slight increase in drop rate may be reflected depending on future circumstances, but at least for the rest of this year, it will remain at its current level without any changes. One of the reasons why players are interested in the pitched boss set is because they're used as proof of why highest tier bosses' level of rewards are too low. So together with the boss reward reorganization direction described above, we will increase the high tier boss's reward level step by step. We have not considered a way to use up items to control their supply and demand yet. First, we will observe the effects of the overall boss reward reorganization. The development team thinks that boss rewards should be determined based on the boss's level of difficulty, and if you defeat the same boss, the total amount of rewards should be the same. Some think that since it is more difficult to defeat a boss solo than in a six-person party, the total amount of rewards should be increased, and conversely, the lower the specs of a character that solos a boss, the more difficult it is, and so the total amount of rewards should be increased. However, many others would find this unreasonable. We think that the core problem is that although bosses have differences in difficulty, the difference in rewards based on difficulty are not big enough. As described above, we expect that this will be gradually improved by adding tradable items as rewards to match the difficulty and by adding a system that changes the intense power crystal's price based on difficulty. In order to prevent problems when distributing boss rewards, we are preparing an option to set the party's reward acquisition permissions to all or party leader only. In addition, we are planning to change certain bosses' individual rewards to shared rewards. It could be possible to solve the distribution problem by changing all current shared rewards to individual rewards. But if this were to be done, then the drop rate would be lowered by the number of party members, and so the variance in the reward acquisition experience could increase. Therefore, the development team's big goal is not to make boss rewards into individual rewards, but in consideration of bosses' unique characteristics or existing experiences, certain bosses will maintain their individual rewards. Reboot World's intense power crystal selling prices will be increased from 3x to 5x. 2. Boss accessibility improvements. The current boss UI removed the existing matching feature and provides only a teleport feature. The ability to move to boss content has become convenient, but we are aware that there is no feature to recruit party members to clear bosses, so it's inconvenient in that sense. We think the need for a boss party member recruitment feature has greatly increased after the Neo update in particular, since the proportion of boss clears has increased. The development team is preparing an improved party matching system. Improved party matching system will not simply form a party with other characters that can enter, but it will match party members based on the highest chance of clearing using characters' specs and past play history. We are currently researching this, and the introduction schedule will be announced separately when it becomes more concrete. We are planning to gradually expand the ability to choose whether or not to do boss pre-quests and quests required to enter content based on if you have already cleared them before in the same world. Improvements were made in the past for bosses that had difficult to obtain entry materials. And in this August's update, we are planning to apply changes to normal Cygnus entry materials to make them easier to get. It will be improved in the August update. After defeating a boss, you can exit by pressing the up arrow key like other portals. In March, the exit method of all boss portals was changed to prevent mistakes and maintain a sense of unity. We were concerned that there would be additional confusion if we applied a different exit method based on the clear status of the boss. But we confirmed that many players still prepared the old play method of exiting bosses using the up arrow key, so we plan to change it so you can do so after the boss is defeated. Character Growth Reorganization. 1. Novice Development and Growth Path Reorganization. Since it is difficult for new and returning users to experience and become familiar with the various content in the game, we will begin to improve this going forward. We will make it easier to adapt to the game with the game guides that use more videos. We are planning a major overhaul of the Maple Guides base system, guide missions, and rewards with a goal of applying it by this winter. In addition, we will review the application method and timing of providing medals and titles for new users. We will make improvements to the growth path and quest path to reduce inconvenience, and in the development process, we will reorganize it so that you can enjoy a variety of growth paths. In the union growth process, we hope to reduce the negative experiences of having to repeat the same entry quests repeatedly by expanding the per-world skip feature to apply to already completed entry quests. After checking this change in character growth, we will also consider introducing feature that lets you skip or speed up story cutscenes and dialogue. 2. Hunting experience improvements and hunting ground improvements. We will try to improve the situations where hunting ability is different based on your job by adjusting skills and diversifying the types of maps and monsters to expand the number of optimized hunting grounds available for different job characteristics. We will proceed with the addition of hunting grounds and stages in the second half of the year. In the job improvement process mentioned above, we will adjust each job's different mobility and operation methods to provide a more standardized operating experience and user experience. In order to prevent excessive differences in the number of buff skills used by each job, we are planning to expand the number of pet buffs per pet from 1 to 2. This will be reflected in the August update, and the number of pet buffs will be expanded to 2 even for existing pets with the pet auto buff skill without additional charges. We considered allowing skill macro hotkeys to be put into pet buffs, but since skill macros could include attacking skills in addition to buffs, there were many other things to consider, so we decided on a method that could be introduced more quickly. We confirmed that the experience penalty after dying had a negative effect on the current growth experience, so in the August update we will significantly reduce its duration. For below level 200, the duration will be fixed to 5 minutes, and for level 200 or higher, the duration will be halved. Burning maps were introduced to reduce the difference between popular and unpopular hunting grounds. Therefore, during times when the usage of hunting grounds was low, we stopped burning map stages from increasing to prevent all hunting grounds from becoming stage 10 burning. However, the current actual hunting ground usage time and the time when the burning map stages stop increasing don't match, and we plan to adjust this in the August update. As stated in the guide on the homepage, the burning stage increase currently stops from 10 p.m. to 8 a.m. the next day, but we will change this to be from 2 a.m. to 10 a.m. In addition, starting from the next event, we will adjust the times for events that don't take place at late nights or early mornings to match actual participation records. Elite monsters are intended to be defeated as soon as possible after they appear. We believe that the current elite monster's duration from spawn to disappearance is not too short and will maintain it. Afterwards, we will observe any changes in the number of cleared elite monsters compared to their spawns and confirm if there are any needed adjustments to the timing. In the process of growing characters below level 200, we will improve other hunting grounds to alleviate the issue of specific hunting grounds being overcrowded. And when improving the Maple Guide system, we will increase the level range you can teleport areas to reduce the inconvenience of moving to different maps. We are planning to add new areas for level 280 and higher. However, we are in a situation where we are considering what we should prioritize and focus on between adding new high-level areas and reorganizing the growth path and enhancing stories. We will talk about this again when our direction becomes clearer. We have confirmed that the level 250 section of hunting grounds which were not adjusted in the Neo update was alleviated to some extent by adding the new Lyman area hunting grounds in June. Additional adjustments to the level 250 section will be made in the upcoming winter update. Finding a party and hunting together is one of the important elements of an RPG. However, in MapleStory, the sizes of hunting grounds have gradually decreased, and the ranges of skills have increased over a long period of time to the point where most hunting grounds are most efficient when hunting alone. Since many players have had experience in playing like this for a long time, we do not plan to drastically change the play experience for party hunting currently. But we plan to enhance the fun of party play through boss content and party-only content. In addition, although not immediately, we will review improvements to cross-world party quests in the long term, including measures against bad manners. As mentioned in previous developer comments on the discussion board, increasing the number of link skill slots requires more of you to consider overall balance. In addition, if the duration of wealth acquisition potions was decreased from the current 2 hours to 1 hour or 30 minutes, Meso inflation could intensify due to the increase in the amount of wealth acquisition potions used in their overall time. Therefore, we ask for your understanding that we are not planning to shorten the duration. 3. Measures to expand experience from sources other than hunting. We will provide various options for leveling up by increasing the amount of experience acquired from content other than hunting. We are mainly considering ways to increase the reward experience from currently underutilized content or add new content aimed at acquiring experience. Examples of this from the June update are adding experience rewards to the Arcane River daily quests, improving Monster Park experience efficiency, and adding new Monster Park stages. However, we try to avoid giving additional experience for content which already provides sufficient motivation to play with attractive rewards other than experience. Under this direction, we have no plans to increase the experience from clearing boss content. And as described in the boss reward reorganization, we would like to move in the direction of increasing the tradable item rewards rather than experience. 4. Measures to motivate growth. In order to motivate hunting, we are preparing a way for users to create small communities where they can find players with similar preferences such as various content. Bosses or dressing up communicate with each other and play together. In order to motivate leveling up in addition to the merit of direct spec ups based on level, we think that there should be more content which can be enjoyed as a character gets stronger. Other than adding high level areas, we want to provide more motivation and goals for growth by diversifying the difficulty of boss content. In addition, we considered linking other systems like achievements as a means of motivating character growth. But it is optional content and it could feel like another hurdle, so we are leaving it as optional motivation like it is right now. Achievements don't give any additional rewards other than achievement points right now, so in the future, we will avoid providing rewards that help grow through achievements if possible. 5. Convenience improvements. In order to solve the lack of setup inventory slots, we are planning to apply a change in the August update so that you can use up to 5 chair and title bags. In the August update, we are planning to add a damage to normal monsters hyper stat and a hyper stat preset feature. We are trying to match the reset times as the current weekly reset days are different for each content. However, it may be difficult to apply this immediately because there are many types of data that need to be settled and reset, and we need to make additional considerations due to changes in reset times. We will try to make adjustments to unify reset times as soon as possible. And the development team is planning to adjust the standard daily reset time to 10 a.m. and the standard weekly reset time to 10 a.m. on Mondays. We are going to make improvements to monster collection in the August update. In order to improve convenience, we are lowering for the around Victoria Island, Aqua Road, Nihil Desert, Yu Lung Dojo medal reward requirements. Changing the Monster Collection Expedition boxes to be store-ageable, and changing certain untradeable awards to be store-ageable. We also plan to add an Expedition Cancel feature. VAC Pets downwards loot range will be increased in the August update. We plan to apply it as 60% of the upwards range. Changes to the MVP additional experience 50% coupons trade status or a reorganization of the Cross Hunter shop will be checked and reviewed after the boss rewards reorganization. 6. Reboot world improvements. Arcane River droplet stones have a very low drop rate and are material that was intended to be obtained through trading. We have decided that selling them in event meso shops was helpful for the supply and demand in reboot world where you cannot trade. So in the second half of the year, we are planning to sell them in Reboot World's shops for mesos at all times. However, alleviating the supply and demand of core gemstones should take into account the growth experiences of users of all worlds. Not just Reboot World, so we will first analyze the overall user experience and value of trading. Thank you.